We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne. And over the last 8 weeks, we've been hitting all of the new products that have hit the market in 2021. And we feel that we're in a position now to be able to tell you about our best players' distance irons of the year. But before we get started, let us just tell you a little bit about which irons fit into this category. We use a forgiveness category to be able to show you which irons fit into each different area of the market. And we tend to work from 1 to 5. So a blade would be number 1, a hybrid would be number 5, and everything else would fit in between those two. Just tell us a bit more about them, Neil.
Yeah, so as you can see, so your category in 1, like Simon's just said, guys, you tend to find your bladed irons, which you show obviously less forgiveness, normally traditional lofts, and traditional, I mean, up to 34s, 35s, so you're not going to get your 35 degree, that would be, you're not going to get your maximum distance. Not a huge amount of technology in there either. Onto category 2, there would be a handicap guide, obviously, with these as well, Simon, and there we say 4 and below for the blade. Now, this is only a guide. We know that some guys out there are better ball strikers than what their handicap suggests because of all their issues, short game, for instance, anything like that. But it's only a guide, guys. But you generally find your better ball strikers or your lower handicaps. So you can see there, 4 and below for your bladed style. 2, your player's iron. Again, not a huge amount of technology in there, traditional lofts. Sometimes you get a little bit of faster face there, but anything where you get be 8 and below for category 2.
Okay.
Into your player's distance iron, which for me is probably my favourite category. You're looking into a little bit of technology now, guys. Your faster face, sometimes a little bit stronger lofts.
Okay, and that is the area that we are looking at.
Today, this is the test that we're covering now. Okay. 12 and below is a guide. Remember, it's only a guide.
Yes.
Category 3, you're looking for your mid-handicap iron. So anything 10 and above, that's where you tend to get a little bit more forgiveness now in your irons. Probably a little bit bigger, a little bit more offset. Then your high handicap irons, your beginners sort of standard really, or 28 handicap, your guys who can't generally break 100, you tend to be in this sort of area, Simon. And then obviously 5 being your hybrid irons, your ultimate forgiveness, distance. If you struggle with speeds, then that'd be the way to go.
Great, okay. And we will show you in this video about how the different categories compare for launch and spin and everything else that you need to know. Okay, let's move on and let's have a look at how all of the models compare in terms of data. We've created this data inside using a GC quad launch monitor and a Callaway Chromesoft X golf ball. And we've used the Callaway Chromesoft X because when you tested it last year, Neil, you were you really liked the feel of the golf ball, so you're thinking about making the switch to it.
Yes, Simon, I feel like the Chromesoft X has been a fantastic golf ball for tests, and I feel like it gave consistent data throughout the test, whether it be wedges, mid irons, and it also, most importantly for me, gave great ball speed numbers off driver, which gave me maximum distance.
Okay, to get started, we get a huge amount of questions, Neil, about dispersion. Why don't we show what happens in terms of dispersion? We tend to use drop-off, and why do we look at 3 different categories of drop-off in this specific category?
Yeah, so going to the dispersion one first, Simon. First example would be if I was to hit one 30 yards left of target and one 30 yards right, it's going to give me an average of 0, when really it's not really an accurate average. And another thing with dispersion is the testing or the ball striking that I present on a certain day might be different to the next day. And we've seen that in the past, haven't we, where we've tested on different days due to a number of things, physical attributes, things like that really, if you feel tired. So, do you know what I mean? There's so much to it.
So just to give an example, that one day it might be 5 yards that Neil can hit into, but the following day, the following week, it might be 20 yards.
Yeah.
You know, so it's very misleading to make claims based on one day's.
And all golfers could probably relate to that as well, Simon. You know, you go to the golf course one day, have a great game, and you play the next day, and it's like you never touched a club before. Do you
absolutely
know what I mean?
Absolutely. So if we move on then, we use 3 different categories for this specific category of irons.
Just to make it so accurate that players' distance iron, so your better golfer would be looking at, who's looking for a little bit more forgiveness maybe, your better ball striker, So if we look at ball speed drop off, backspin drop off, and carry distance drop off, we've got the three main things covered there, really.
Okay, so anything that has got the player's title is all about consistency as well as that bit of
correct.
Distance as well.
And that's why the backspin numbers are there.
Okay, so just talk us through what happened here, because it's pretty interesting.
Yeah, you know? So one thing I want to add, Taryn, is I think if you were to score in the top three of any of these categories, you got a good club there. The thing that's really striking me there is the TaylorMade, the P770, to be one in ball speed drop-off, to be one in backspin drop-off, and to be two in carry distance drop-off. Now, as we know, it probably isn't the longest of the TaylorMade, but those numbers there, Simon, are very, very impressive for me.
Okay, and also just to say, you know, about the PXG as well, because this isn't just a trait that we've seen in this category, we've seen it in other categories as well. Very, very small amount of drop-off.
Yeah, they've done very well. Great product, the PXG, the lineup, isn't it, for this year. And again, they've got two out of three in the top three there in the categories, which is very good.
Okay, so let's move on and have a look at how all 12 irons compare in terms of data. Right, Neil, how do they all compare in terms of distance, ball speed, spin? Because there's some very different numbers here.
Yeah, they're certainly on. This is something that, guys, I really want to highlight, really, is if you've got a club that's really good in carry distance drop-off, don't get carried away with what it's doing in distance, if that makes sense. Because you can see here, Sam, if we just take, let's take the TaylorMade, for instance, the P770 against the P790. Both.
So going top and bottom.
Correct. Yep. So, but have both scored very well in carry distance drop off. But one's got a carry distance in the 790 of 178, and one's got a carry of 163.
It's a 15 yards of difference.
That's a huge difference, isn't it? From the same iron, from a 7-iron. Do you know what I mean? Why I really like this category, and it's interesting, I feel like your better ball strikers now can really get their irons dialed into what they specifically want. If they're not looking for a huge amount of distance, because they generate quite good speeds anyway, then they can look at the Callaway Apex 21 Pros, they can look at your P770s, but you've still got that little bit of forgiveness in there. Or you can go the other way and look at for your P790 or your Strixon ZX fives, and yeah, I'm getting close to the 180 carry mark there out of a player's design, which is phenomenal.
Okay, and just a really important point, you know, we have got the Apex Pro and the P770 down there at the bottom. That some people would argue that they could slide those into the player's iron category. So, but what we'd say is, well, actually, where do the TCB and the P7MC go? Because they're your player's iron. So, it's really important for you to decide what's important to your own game. Is it that smaller shaped head, or is it more distance? Because you've got both on offer within this category. So that's plenty about all 12 models there, about how they compare. But what about the different categories, Neil? Because this is quite interesting as well.
It certainly is. And again, you can look at, I mean, you look at this show, Simon, what you put on the line. But the big one for me is if you sway towards the player's irons, please pay attention to the player's distance irons, because you can see there you can be you're 6 yards up, which is huge, but you're not really losing much in spin. And the peak height, I'm actually getting more peak height now out of the player's distance irons, which I wouldn't thought I'd get over a player's iron. Yeah. So really pay attention to this, guys. It can really help your golf game.
Yeah,
definitely.
It really shows you what is on the line by making the wrong choice. You know, if you're on the board between these categories or going into this side, there is a lot at stake. So just make sure that you make the right choice. Okay, let's move on and have a look at our top performing players' distance irons of 2021. Taking into account everything that we've already told you, these are our top five players' distance irons this year. Just tell us a little bit more about why we've chosen them, Neil. We've already told them loads about the P790s and the PXGs, but
in my opinion, Sam, we've got five fantastic clubs here, and I dare say I could probably use all of them myself. Want to touch upon first that Honma TR20P, fantastic look, definitely one of the best looking at a dress for me. I really like the shape of the head, not too big a top line, not too long looking in terms of the The face behind the golf ball, great feeling club. It gets the thumbs up for me this year, definitely.
Really simple and unfussy as well,
just
isn't it?
Not a lot going on, do you know what I mean? Just really good looking golf club.
Brilliant. Okay, and now on to the Strixon, because 2021 is the year that Strixon have come of age in the Forged Iron market.
Definitely. And again, another great looking club. Slightly different to the rest. I think if you're somebody that likes like a kind of little bit more of a higher toe look, then go towards this. But again, behind the golf ball, lovely, lovely looking. Decent feel as well. Yeah. Compact. That's what I like about most of these, though. They're not too chunky.
Yeah. And also, being able to buy them this year individually is really, really important. So you can mix and match between the two sets.
If you're someone that struggles with those long irons, do you know what I mean? You can get a little bit more forgiveness in there. And then flip the other way. If you want to go smaller heads in the short irons, that's an option.
Okay, and then we can't leave out Mizuno. So the JPX 91 forged,
probably
one of
the nicest feeling irons that I would say. Again, really nice looking. A bit longer in length there over, say, a Hom or something like that, from what I could see it addressed. But in terms of feel, takes some beating time, definitely.
Okay, and we get lots of questions about how to choose between that and the HMB.
Yeah.
Okay, what we saw was about 1 mile an hour more ball speed, about 2 yards more carry distance.
Which I was surprised about, really. If you were to say to me, are you going to hit the HMB further than the Forge? I'd say, yeah, all day long, hollow body, do you know what I mean? But it's quick off the face, that Forge. I think if you're looking at the MP20 HMB, you can't not afford to look at the Forge. You've got to try both, guys.
Okay, and if you have a set budget this year, we can't leave the Ben Hogan out, because the PTX Pro are a really, really nice looking iron. They're not the strongest loft, so you're not going to get the most amount of distance out of them.
No, but again, a great feeling golf club. Like Simon said, traditional lofted. So don't get carried away if you look at the data that we've produced about the distance that it was doing for myself. But again, small top line, quite compact head, felt great. I think it can be difficult to get fitted for those, can't it, Simon?
Yeah, it's online only.
Yeah, so that's the only downside to it. But again, if you are a Ben Hogan fan, great, great golf club.
Okay, guys, that is our best players' distance irons of 2021. If you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.